Ozempic, Wegovy, Monjaro, I am sure you've heard these medications in the news and the media lately. It seems like every celebrity is taking them. The most recent buzz about these medications are surprise pregnancies. So people are posting on social media, I was not trying to get pregnant. I was taking birth control and I was on these medications and I got pregnant by surprise. So are you surprised? Let's learn more about this phenomenon. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine. I'm a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people with fertility for almost 20 years. And I love educating. Thanks for finding this channel. Be sure and subscribe so you get my weekly video. And I've got lots of information at my website, drlorashahine.com, Instagram, TikTok. I just love educating. So social media has been buzzing about women sharing surprise pregnancies while taking these weight loss medications, or maybe for diabetes, these semaglutide medications. Just look up the hashtag Ozempic baby or Monjaro baby and you'll see women sharing their own stories. Now, these are typically surprise pregnancies, and even when women are taking birth control, because most doctors recommend not trying to conceive while you're taking these medications. So what is happening? I'm gonna go over five main topics in this video. Topic number one, we're gonna review exactly what semaglutides are and how they work. Topic number two, we're gonna go over the recommendations for people who are trying to conceive. Topic number three, we're gonna review how could people be getting pregnant when they're using birth control or these surprise pregnancies while they're taking these medications. Topic number four, we're gonna answer the question, can people take semaglutides and try to conceive? And topic number five, should you worry if you are taking semaglutides and you are not ready to get pregnant? Topic number one, what are semaglutides? Semaglutides are a class of medications that were designed to treat diabetes, and they were found to have a very interesting side effect, weight loss. And the companies, as well as people, started realizing that this is happening, and people started talking about it. Celebrities started taking the medications for weight loss. The pharmaceutical companies started designing different brands at different doses in order to use these medications for weight loss. And they come under lots of different names. So Ozempic, Wegovy, Monjaro are just some of them. There's lots of different mechanisms for these medications, but one of the ways that it causes weight loss is a slowing of gastric emptying. So when the food gets into the stomach, it just takes longer to kind of get out of the stomach and through into the intestines. And so you will feel like eating less. There are also some side effects like GI side effects and stomach cramps. That's other reasons why people feel like eating less. So it's typically the calorie restriction from a couple of different reasons that is associated with the weight loss. Of course, everyone is different, but that's the general understanding. Topic number two, recommendations if you're trying to conceive and thinking about or you're taking semaglutides. The recommendation is to not take semaglutides when you're trying to conceive and to stop them at least 2 months before you're actively trying to get pregnant. The reason is in some animal studies, there have been shown an increased risk of miscarriage and birth defects. These have not been shown to happen in humans, but with the animal studies and no long-term studies on humans yet, the recommendation is better to be safe than sorry and to stop semaglutides before you're actively trying to conceive. Topic number three, why are people getting pregnant when they're not even trying to and they're taking these semaglutides, even if they're using birth control? So two theories. Theory number one is that just weight loss in and of itself can often improve chances of getting pregnant. Not for everyone. People can be fertile at different weights, but there are some people when they lose weight, it helps with the hormonal access and communication. Ovulation starts happening more regularly. There's better hormonal communication and immune communication in the luteal phase when the embryo is trying to implant. So there are people reporting who have been infertile for years. Some studies in patients with PCOS or polycystic ovarian syndrome, et cetera, where they're getting pregnant even when they aren't actually trying. And it's probably because of these benefits surrounding the benefits of weight loss. Again, everybody is different and this is a theory, but it makes logical sense. So theory number two as to why people are getting pregnant, especially if they're taking birth control with these semaglutides. Well, this goes to that delayed gastric emptying theory, because most people that are reporting using birth control and getting pregnant on semaglutides are using oral birth control pills. And oral birth control pills, if there's delayed gastric emptying, it could really alter absorption and how the oral birth control pill is functioning in the body. So that could be the reason that the oral birth control methods are less effective. Now, of course, there could be people that might be conceiving with other types of birth control, but this is what I've seen the most and what the theory is the most about lately with the information that we have right now. So topic number four. So if people are getting pregnant with semaglutides, can you try to conceive while you're taking semaglutides? The answer is no. So again, to those animal studies showing increases of miscarriage and birth defects, it's better to be safe than sorry and stop the semaglutides at least 2 months before you're actively trying to conceive. We may learn more in the future, but this is the recommendation for right now. Topic number five, if you're taking semaglutides and you don't want to get pregnant, should you worry? Well, talk to your doctor, think about your birth control method, maybe think about more than one birth control method. We're still learning about this. We have a lot to learn, but this is definitely something that's out there. People are talking about it. There's a little bit of theories as to why this could be happening. So if you really don't want to get pregnant and you're taking a semaglutide, think about your birth control method. Talk to your doctor about all the options that are available to you. I hope you learned something from this video. I love teaching. Like this video if you learned something. Comment with questions that you have. Be sure and subscribe to this channel so you get my weekly video all about reproductive health. And until next week, I'm wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.